Hey, what's up, guys? Theragoth here, and today, what do I have for you guys today? Well, I'm speechless after this gameplay, even though it might not be the most ridiculous score, 63-8, which is in my mind pretty good. Maybe not in the eyes of the general republic of the YouTubers per se, but when you realize about how well those deaths were each represented, you're gonna realize how insane this gameplay actually is. I don't even know what I was doing there, but from here on out, it just gets insane. But so basically, here's the idea of the gameplay. I get six attack helicopters, five Reapers, and six Predator missiles, which means that I went on, six kill streaks, which is 36 gun kills at the very least, plus my Reapers. So you have to figure you're looking at about 40 plus gun kills in this gameplay. So then add 40 plus 23, so I got 23 kill streak kills, 40 gun kills, just ridiculous. And this is what I believe, probably not, but I believe it to be maybe a record for most attack helicopters slash Reapers in one game. Even if it's not, I'm still gonna title it as such because I believe it is. I did a little searching. I searched most attack helicopters in one game, and nobody really big has ever done any type of video like this. But what I did find is a four attack helicopter game, a five attack helicopter game, but none with six and none with such a high kill death ratio. Not to talk up the game any more than I already have, but I feel like I would have probably broken 80 kills possibly in this gameplay if they weren't, what's the word I'm looking for? Air support taker downer whores? Because these guys, they have their Stinger missiles happy up the butt, but I think in the end it actually started paying dividends to me, because even though they were taking them down at such a fast rate, that just allowed me to get on my kill streak even quicker. So, hypothetically, if they weren't taking down myself, yeah, I probably would have broken 80 kills, but I would probably wouldn't have had so many attack helicopters and Reapers. And right there, you see, well, like a few minutes or a few seconds ago, you saw me with the FMG9s. And or one FMG9 silenced, actually. I took out two guys, and this is something I really want to stress. Don't push any fights that you think you're gonna lose. I saw that I was probably gonna lose to that guy that was in the building. I was running out of ammo. He had an assault rifle, and I only had an FMG9 silenced. A, from a longer range, it just won't be effective. And B, I felt like maybe already being on low health, that's just a gunfight I wouldn't win. So I retreated, backed up, waited for him to come out, and I was able to pick him off and pick up my Reaper. If I had gone in there, I have a strong feeling that I probably would have died. And here I'm calling in either my second or my third attack helicopter. And I'm actually one away from a Reaper again, because what I had done is my first kill streak was like 14, and I feel like I was actually kind of close to a MOAB there, but then that Predator missile just ends my kill streak. One away from a Reaper, one away from glory. But another thing I want to talk about is, whew, I forgot what I wanted to talk about. Oh yeah, it'll come up later in this gameplay. When I do it, I'll show you guys. But when I got this gameplay, I was excited. I wanted to upload it. I feel like Christmas has just given me all these great gameplays, and I get this guy. I probably should have died there. I mean, I play on a 2 sensitivity, and if I'm able to even turn on a person at all, that just means that I was to get lucky, because that person should have killed me. And I just want to show you guys something right here. Check this out. Look at that art. Now look at the bottom of the screen. Look at all those green lines. That is just ridiculous. This Reaper go or no. The Reaper that I get in a little bit just goes off on these guys. And not only that, that's just the most, like, I would say consistent I've ever seen. Like, this is such a consistent gameplay. Like, from start to finish, you just see green lines and, like, very little red lines. Besides for at the beginning where I got two quick deaths. But besides for that, it's the most consistent gameplay I've probably seen on my own channel, for the very least. And I'm trying to slow up talking too fast, so I need to calm down. Because I'm gonna admit to you guys, I'm still not the best commentator. Certainly not even close. But I'm trying to get there, and I feel like one of the main things is me not talking as fast. And I just recognize the fact right now that I was talking maybe a little bit too fast, and I'm slowing it down. Now, if you guys didn't know this, the numbers that you see right on the right above where the Reaper directional thing is, it says some numbers. That's how far away the Reaper missile is to the ground. So when it hits around like zero, that means that it's actually hitting the ground. So you could actually kind of time it well if you want to like surprise attack a person or something like that. and I think that was my third Reaper, I want to say. And I'm just going to go over here and start tearing people up. And you could argue that this gameplay was a little bit defensive. But, you know, relative to other, like, records I've seen, like, world records I've seen, I don't know if this is one, but I'm just saying, they're even more defensive than this. I actually played, in my opinion, relatively aggressive if you're comparing it to other gameplays like this I've seen. And here is another point in which I should have died, but I just get lucky and my teammate picks him up, just because there's an overwhelming amount of us. And here I pick up an M4A1. Doesn't really do anything for me. Alright, here's a situation I wanted to talk about here. I know that there's a guy in here. I don't want to run out and just kill him, because I'm just going to die if I turn that corner. Let him come to me, pick him off. Now I come over here. No. I go back over here because I know there's another guy, right? I see him, but he's hiding in a position where I don't think I can beat him. So what I do is I just throw my flash because I know I need my attack helicopter. He's completely done right now. Use my predator missile, get a triple kill, and get my Reaper just like that. No need for doing anything extreme and going in there and getting him. I knew that I was safe right in this position after I threw my flash grenade, and I was not going to risk losing a potential kill streak just to pick up a guy because I had a big head about myself and think that I could just run in there and get him, because personally I don't think I would have been able to kill him. On that same note, this Reaper drone I think is a little bit overpowered. It's probably I don't want to say better than the AC-130, that might start an uproar in the community, even though nobody's going to watch this video. No, yeah, I got my guys watching the video. You guys that watch this video, I love you all. No hate. Just masturbate. That's disgusting, actually. Just kidding. But I don't want you masturbating to my videos. That's just disgusting. Anyways, but yeah, anybody who watches this video, I love you so much. And I really hope you're enjoying, because I'm trying to put out content, you know, a lot of content, not just like little amounts of content. And I'm just playing Call of Duty so much over this break so I could bring you guys great content like this, because I do recognize the fact that maybe my content before wasn't like the best that you would have seen, but it was still good. Now I'm just trying to bring the best content possible, and I think a game in which I get 6 attack helicopters is pretty good content. And here we go, pick up another guy. And I had just prestiged, I'm 6 prestige now, level 27 at the moment. And another thing that I do that I feel a lot of commentators don't do, all the gameplay that I get and record my voice over, I literally get that day or one day before that day. I don't sit there storing up gameplay for like a month and then just upload videos that like come out every day. Like I won't do like 10 videos in a day then upload them over a period of 10 days, because I just find that that's being lazy, and you could have provided that information 10 days earlier. For example, I don't want to call anyone out, but there's a person that does a lot of tips and tricks guides. And, actually, I call people out all the time. Raw Instinct, I believe is his name, or L2 Instinct, or whatever his name is. I like him, I'm subscribed to him, but, I noticed that his gameplays and the tips and tricks that he does are all from, like, months ago, even. He knew that he was gonna be doing that series far into, probably even before the game was released. And he probably stored up all the, I would even imagine they stored up the footage for the gameplays even before the game had even been released, as those bigger YouTubers get their hands on the game early. And here we go, calling in my, I'm still very sick, calling in my 6th attack helicopter for the world record, in my opinion. But then again, my opinion doesn't really matter in the Call of Duty community, but if it did, that would be it. And as we're wrapping up the game here, I just want to remind you guys that I appreciate every like, comment, and subscription that I get every day. I read every single comment and every single video response. And besides that, guys, peace out. Love you all. Fried chicken.